Hello, you're watching Proactive New York. Joining me this morning is Gerald, Commissiong, CEO at Todos Medical. Gerald, good to see you. How are you?
Doing well, thank you. How are you?
I'm good. Thanks for asking. Gerald, we are seeing the volume of coronavirus tests being done at your Provista lab in Atlanta really ramp up here. Tell us a bit more about that.
Well, you know, as we've talked about, we'd spent a lot of time building up the automation, doing the scripting, and putting all the pieces together to be able to report. And that, you know, took quite a bit of time in the second and the third quarter. We did get that in place so that in the fourth quarter, we could start to really ramp. And through one of our reference lab agreements, we started to help schools do testing and do mass screening programs. And so as we gained that experience and we started to get our volume, we've now worked through a lot of the kinks in terms of integrating. And now we think we're really ready to scale. So, you know, we've gone through, we've tested it. We know we can do the automation in high volume. Our lab is trained. Now we're in the process of, you know, staggering starts and hiring more personnel so we can start to meet the demand. And that's really, you know, being worked well through our new sales team that we brought on.
So how many tests are you doing and how many would you expect to do?
So the maximum we've done so far is about 1,000 in a day, but that really only took us about 3 hours to get done with the automation. And that was only using, you know, less than half of our capacity at that point in time. So, you know, as we ramp and we bring on additional personnel, we'll be able to run these machines, you know, all at the same time. And we think we can get, you know, pretty easily up to 10,000 a day. And from there, you know, throughout the rest of November, we've brought on a number of strategic consulting groups to help us optimize the workflow to get up to 20. And so, you know, it's all about the reporting and making sure that the reports get out in a timely fashion, because the faster we report, the more valuable the information, you know, the better it is for customers. And then, you know, the more the word spreads that we can deliver.
I know you can't say a lot, but what might this mean for revenue numbers here?
Well, you know, we did put, you know, average pricing on a direct basis, about $130. On a reference basis, it's, you know, less than that and maybe about half of that. But, you know, given our margins and our distributor pricing, because our Corona Diagnostics subsidiary actually distributes, we have much higher margins than other labs. And so we can continue to compete on volume. We see large volume accounts really being the driver of growth for us. And that's really driven by the fact that, you know, a lot of these commercial labs, they don't want to do the work, but, you know, they want to get paid. And so the ability of those labs to continue to make good margins, but referencing to us, and for us, really, it being a volume game. So the more business we get, you know, obviously, the better we get in terms of pricing and the more we can do. We think it's a nice kind of hand in glove, because that really fits our kind of almost external business development. They're the ones facing the customer. They're the ones dealing with all the issues. They're the ones collecting. And all we have to do is get, you know, information and the actual samples, and we can turn them around extremely fast. So we think that, you know, this could ramp quite substantially. We have seen other labs get upwards of $10 million a month. We're nowhere near that yet, but we think as we continue to build our volume, we can get to those numbers.
Good to get an understanding there. Separately, I do want to get an update on your clinical trial with Tollovir, your phase two clinical trial. You've added another site here. So what does this mean for your potential coronavirus treatment?
Well, so for us, you know, it's all about getting an interim data point, really mining that data to the best of our ability based upon all the new information out there. So certainly, you know, we're going to look at endpoints, not only clinical endpoints that are known, you know, mortality, obviously time in the ICU, people who went on ventilator, time in the hospital, but also some other biomarker data. And then looking at, you know, some, we won't get them all because not all the patients will have been long enough, but some longer term data, you know, who are these patients who may be getting long COVID, and can we reduce that? Based on some of the mechanistic work that's come out in the last week to 2 weeks on the role of the 3CL protease in sensitizing the immune system so that there is a robust response. We're hopeful that, you know, we can see increased antibody response in response to treatment. with Tollovir. So what we found, anecdotally, is that, patients who do take Tollovir, they have a strong antibody response, and that antibody response does appear to be happening a little bit sooner than would be typical. So you see IgM come up sooner, you see IgG come up sooner, and you see some pretty strong bands when you're looking at some of these rapid tests. That's hopeful, but that's not hard data. We think if we can confirm that with hard data and really start to understand that, Tollovir is not only stopping the virus from replicating, but also strengthening the immune system at the same time, that would really be a big win for patients.
Really appreciate the update here, Gerald. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.